Welcome to Proclaim, a presentation of the Catholic Diocese of Alexandria. Join us as we journey together through the Scriptures revealed to us by God.
Good morning and welcome to Proclaim. As we now begin chapter 5 in the Gospel of Mark, we again see a new setting being offered to us. It says, they came to the other side of the sea in the territory of the Gerasenes. Remember that chapter 4 ended with the calming of the sea and the awe and astonishment of the disciples, which seems to be their common expression. This particular description of where they landed is again difficult to really understand, and it perhaps is another illustration of Mark's rather inexact knowledge of the geography of Palestine, because what's going to ultimately happen here is talking about a water body, and yet at least this particular town that seems to be referred to is about 30 miles from the lake, which leaves some questions open-ended. But of course, it's not about geography, it's about what happens in the ministry of Jesus that the gospel writer is most concerned about. And so, having told us where they are, he said, when he got out of the boat, at once a man from the tombs who had an unclean spirit met him. Now, this basic story is contained in other Gospels, but the vividness that we'll see in Mark's story is, again, one of those characteristics that for many, many centuries was largely ignored. Mark was thought to be an abbreviation of Matthew, and so why bother with the abbreviation when you can go directly to Matthew? And so Matthew certainly had the prominence that Mark lacked. But as more recent scholars have examined it in greater depth and greater detail, what's become apparent is the vividness of Mark's narration is far more that of someone who was intimately connected with someone who saw and was there, which certainly fits with the understanding that Mark was in some way reflecting the ministry and the way in which Peter tells the story.
This program was brought to you by Kramer Funeral Home.